and welcome back to From the Tech Desk by your RC experts in your RS hobby. I'm your host, Brad Brooker. Today we're talking about how easy it is to switch out your servo in the Axial Ryft. So it's time to switch out your servo or your Ryft. You'll need a servo, a battery, 2mm wrench, or a speed driver, and your transmitter. Well, let's get started. First, we're going to start by taking the old servo out. So we're going to start taking the receiver box out to get to the servo plug. Two screws on top. We'll flip the truck over. Next are three screws here, the little triangle screws there. This will allow you to pull the receiver box out. You'll flip it upside down there. Next, you'll take the four screws off the actual top of the receiver box. Remove the receiver box lid. This allows you access to the receiver. So let's go ahead and take the servo out now as well. Four screws here on the servo mount you'll want to remove. We'll flip the truck back over. And also you'll want to remove the servo saver as well. Once you get those four screws out, you're going to unattach your servo saver. You want to flip the truck back over again. We'll go ahead and plug the servo now. Go pull that old one out. Now it's time to install the new servo. All right, now it's time to install the new servo. One thing to do to make sure is make sure it's sitting in there in the correct orientation of the previous servo. So go ahead and feed the servo lead through. The servo next. One thing you'll want to do as well this time, I like to go ahead and mount the servo in place. This is a preference. You can either run the wire, but I like to get it mounted lock solid before I run the wire. Go ahead and install it. Put your four screws back in. Now it's time to route the wire and plug it into the receiver. Also, when routing it to the actual receiver box, allow a little slack just for movement, especially with the travel of the axle and everything. And also, make sure you put the wire inside the actual rubber grommet. That's for waterproofing as well, so make sure you feed it right that way as well. So once you have it through the rubber grommet, you go ahead and plug it in. Make sure you have it in channel 1. And make sure you have the polarity correct as well on the actual plug. Plug it into the receiver. You can go ahead and wrap the wire in the receiver box. Also, when installing a new servo in your SR6100AT receiver, you will have to redo calibration for the AVC. So just a heads up, you will have to redo that. Before you get all buttoned up, you want to make sure you have that set up and ready to go before everything's all done. Once you have the servo installed, now it's time to install the servo horn. A few things we want to do prior to that, we'll want to fire up the truck so we have to make sure the servo is centered itself. And also you want to make sure your transmitter is on. And when your transmitter is on, make sure the throw is 100% and also everything is zeroed out on your steering. Go ahead and turn your truck on. Go ahead and initialize and set. I usually like to turn the wheel just back and forth one time, let it center itself, go up with the servo horn on, make sure it's centered when you're putting it on, go ahead and start your screw here. I'm not going to tighten down all the way, I'm just going to start it, and we'll tighten down once the vehicle is turned off, so we have no added stress onto the servo. Alright, go turn the vehicle off. Tighten down the servo saver here. We're going to tighten this up, we're going to turn everything back on. Now we're going to set our endpoints to make sure our throw is okay. Yep, everything looks good. There's no added stress on the equipment. There you have it. That's how quick and easy it is to change the servo on your Axial Ryft. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for other helpful videos from your RC experts here at Horizon Hobby.